Hello friends, in the series of BSc IPF, I welcome you all. We are talking and we will be discussing about a topic which is not very much regular in personal finance or not very much common in personal finance. But that topic is very much vital, which is impact cost. Do you remember when we have heard about it? Yes, you are right. While discussing riskometer of equity mutual funds, there was the concept called impact cost. Along with MCAP, the important tool which we discussed is impact cost, which is a measure of liquidity. If this video you are watching for a very first time, then there is a separate playlist on our YouTube channel called Riskometer. You can visit our YouTube channel and know in detail about the Riskometer, whether it is equity mutual fund or debt mutual fund. One more important thing, that all these sessions are coming to you by BSC, IPF and SEBI because they took this initiative and they want each common and small investor to get empowered with knowledge and information. So don't forget to say them thanks after this session. Come on friends, let us talk about impact cost. If I am a trader and if I want to buy a stock, buy a share, then there will be a bid price, ask price, there will be an order book. If you are regular trader, then all this you must be familiar with all these terminologies. Even if you are not, then if I want to buy share A, then I'll have to look at the prices of best sell, because at what price seller wants to sell their stocks. If I am a seller, I'll have to look at the price at what price buyer, best price buyer want to buy that stock. So this is how best buy and best sell thing works. What is impact cost? If stock A is there and best difference between best buy and best sell is say 5 rupees, 100 and 105. So if 5 rupees is the difference, if this difference is more, then the cost of execution will be there. That means this stock is not very much liquid. It is an impact cost represents the cost of executing the transaction in a given stock for a specific predefined order size at any given point of time. So it differs with order size also. Impact cost is practical and realistic measure of market liquidity. If the difference is more, best buy and best sell price, if this difference is more, if there is a huge gap between these two prices, then there is no liquidity or less liquidity. So we can compare the stock prices with the others and we can get the idea whether the stock is liquid or not. Then impact cost is separately computed for buy and sell. And then impact cost may vary. You must not be, it is not visible computed for buy and sell. Whenever we are doing calculations, we will do separate calculations for buy and we will do separate calculations for selling also. Impact cost may vary from different transaction size. Say there will be a different impact cost if we are doing a trade of 40,000 stocks, then impact cost will be different. If we are doing a trade of 20,000 stocks, then impact cost will be different. So according to the transaction sizes, impact cost will differ. As we have talked about it in the very first point, that impact cost is separately computed for buy and sell. We will do the separate calculations for each transaction, whether we are buying or selling. Then impact cost is dynamic and it depends upon the outstanding order and where the stock is not sufficiently liquid, penal impact cost is applied. So if there is no liquidity, then penal cost will be applied. If impact cost is more, stock is less liquid. If impact cost is less, stock is more liquid. So this is how impact cost is measured. We will come up with an example for calculating the impact cost in next video. Till then, stay tuned. Keep watching our videos. Thank you very much for liking our sessions. Don't forget to write your name along with your email address in the comment section, because that is mandatory. The same topic is done in Marathi and Hindi. You can check out our YouTube channel. Stay tuned.